Welcome. Thank you for joining happyandbetter.tv. We are so grateful to you. And you guys are so kind in your comments and your suggestions. And we are also very thankful for those. You know, it was Bob Marley who said, "One love, one life. Let's get together and feel all right." Well, our guest today is helping us do that. Mr. Craig Knight of 88.1 Radio. How are you today?
All right, how are you?
Great, thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
And you guys are doing some great expansions and capital investments, I hear.
Well, yeah, there's something big going on in the historic West Las Vegas. And some people may not have heard, but I'm sure people on the freeway has drove by on the freeway to 15 and seen a whole lot of construction going on. And what's happening is the building we were in was a 1923 school. It was the first elementary school in Nevada, in Las Vegas, actually. Yes.
Interesting. What was the name of that? You know?
At the time, I don't recall the name, but it became the West Side School.
Uh-huh.
So around 1948, they built an expansion of it, and I guess because of the population growth. And during the migration of African Americans into Las Vegas, they started migrating on the west side of town. And then that became the first black elementary school for African Americans.
Wow.
Yeah. So then at this point, fast forward today, it becomes, it's an historic landmark on the National Registry.
Nice.
So the city of Las Vegas.
That original school.
Yes.
From 1928, you said?
1923.
Great.
So the National Preservation and National Registry has put it on the map, and the city of Las Vegas have received some grant funds and other kind of funds and credits, and you know, I don't know all of the genre, the jargon on that.
That's a formal process to become a historical landmark.
Yes.
It means you have to go through a multitude of steps.
Oh, yes.
And in addition, you can't just come up and decide, "Oh, we're going to paint it white like the White House." No.
Right, no.
Everything is determined in advance, and you have to get permission. And it's quite an honor, an honor. That's wonderful.
So it's moving right along, and we moved the radio station. We've been in that particular building for 32 years.
Really?
So the space we're moving into is renovation. It's a rehabilitation project. So the 1948 building was renovated, so we moved into that space, and it's been updated technical-wise so we can have, broadcast from there. And the building we was in, the original 1923 school, is being renovated into its original state or look or appearance, and it's going to be made a museum bookstore.
Is that right?
Yes.
Wow, that's going to be wonderful. So is it going to be like a museum showing what the school was like when it was the first school for Las Vegas? How wonderful.
Yep. And as a matter of fact, the West Side School Alumni Association, and it's a group of people who actually graduated and went to that, attended that school.
Nice.
So they're part of the whole process of making it, you know, the museum, you know, contributing, you know, old relics and whatnot and information to kind of put that museum project together.
Yes, indeed. That's going to be wonderful. The other part of that is with you moving next door, what are you guys going to do in this rehabilitated building?
Well, actually, what we're doing, we've able to expand and upgrade our whole technical side of broadcasting.
Nice.
So we was able to upgrade to new equipment. You know, and it was a much needed thing because a lot of the equipment the radio station had was 20 years old, 15 years old, and it was kind of makeshift to put together. So this created an opportunity to force us to upgrade, and it worked out, you know, through our fundraising and our drives and whatnot. So the community played a role in it. We have donors that played a role in it. So we were able to upgrade the radio station to where we have three HD channels now.
Wonderful. What are the channels?
All right, HD1 is our regular programming that you hear every day on the radio.
That's the 88.1.
88.1 FM. And HD2 is going to be 24/7 gospel. We're looking to launch that
next
year.
Wow, that's wonderful.
And then HD3 is going to be a teen radio channel because it's part of our internship program that we've always had there for high school and college students.
That is great.
Thank you.
88.1 is fabulous.
Thank you.
I love it. I remember when I first moved here, it was my companion. As I would just ride down the main streets trying to learn my way around the city, I would take a street like Sahara every day and just start at Fort Apache, go all the way down to the end and turn around and come back and look at the other side. And I listened to 88.1 all the way. Loved it, loved it.
Yes.
You guys give a lot of community news, which is really great.
Yes.
But for 88.1, many people like myself would not know what's going on in the city. So you bring a lot of vision and diversity into your programming. And I love, like I said, the community programs.
Absolutely.
I love the community announcements that you make. Now, you said you've upgraded your equipment when you moved next door and rehabilitated that building. And what kind of equipment did you upgrade in there?
Well, we have a state-of-the-art generator now, and the station, I don't recall any time in its history having a state-of-the-art generator to where if there's a power outage, even if it's in the city, it kicks on. It takes about 20 seconds to kick on, and it puts us right back.
You mean, we all know what a blackout is.
Yes.
When the power goes, your radio station goes.
Everything goes.
Everything goes. So you're saying with this new generator, you guys can pop back on the air.
We have backup batteries that last approximately 20 seconds, and it takes the generator 15 to 20 seconds to kick in. So there's a segue period when the power goes out.
That is so important to know because God forbid there be an emergency.
Absolutely.
We know that we could always hear 88.1.
Yes.
Even if the other stations are down.
Right.
For a power outage.
Yes.
Well, that's good to know. Very good information.
Yes.
What about your wattage? Did that change at all?
Our wattage is still 10,000 watts, and that's what's coming off the tower. However, we've upgraded to digital technology, digital streaming. Mm-hmm. That's what made us high definition, which that's what HD stands for.
The new channels,
The new channels, and also the main channel is on HD too.
Okay.
So as well, what can happen is you can pick us up on your laptop, your computer, your desktop, your phone, your tablet, you know, or if you have an HD radio in your car, you can pick up all three channels.
Nice.
But if you don't have an HD radio, that's fine. You just pick up the main channel. And it's clear, crystal clear digital streaming, which is like CD quality.
Wow, that is wonderful. It's nothing like, I'm anticipating, I'm already waiting to get this full-time 24-hour gospel station.
Oh yeah, yes.
Because like they say, trouble comes in the evening. So, you know, whenever it comes, you can turn on that gospel station and get some uplifting. That's wonderful.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
As general manager, Craig, thank you for having the foresight and your board.
Mm-hmm.
Thank all of you. Thank you, because you're adding so much to our community.
You're welcome.
Now, with this new internship and program you're going to have, what are you going to do with the teens?
Well, actually, we have a teen talk show that we do now every Saturday at 12 noon, and it's called KCP Teen Talk Radio. And with the when we're up and running with the HD3 channel, what's that going to do? It's going to open up the training. So it's beyond just training to be an on-air personality. But there are some teenagers out there that might not have the talent to be an on-air personality or a DJ, but then they can train to be a music director or a program director or a sales rep, you know, behind the scenes. So it gives us an opportunity to expose them to the real radio world, to get some experience, so when they go on from high school to college and even after college, they will have gained some experience.
That is so wonderful, because our young people, and period, all over the world, are so talented.
Yes.
And they are so smart.
Yes,
I look
they
at
are.
Them in
yeah.
awe. I'm very, very proud of our young people.
Yes.
So it's good to know that even if they can't be the DJ,
right,
they can still do other things and get training. I read recently that the DJs on the Strip were making as much as $400,000 per night.
Yeah, that's the resident club DJs.
Did we go into the wrong field?
No, I've been in the right field. It just changed, and you know, things
That's
changed.
That's true. You were in that.
I helped build that field.
Yes, you did.
But
yes,
I didn't benefit
did.
From the end result yet.
Yes, you did. And just in case someone's new to Vegas, tell them how you used to give promotions and.
Oh yeah,
events.
When I started out as a DJ, my DJ name was Smooth C, and I used to do live remote DJing for radio stations in the club, mix shows on the air, and then I also did live entertainment events like after work mix and mingles, and I would hire local bands and give them a chance to put on a show, you know, and it became a series. It started out at the Stardust. The former Stardust, and that was it started there in 2000, and I think it was 2002 or 2003, and it lasted for like until the Stardust, you know, was imploded.
Yes. Then,
you know, and we had a farewell going away event there for that, and then the same people that were Boy Gaming that had the Stardust, they were over at the Orleans, so they was able to let us continue it over there at the Orleans Hotel, and then it just kept going and going until 2008.
Well, it was great, and that's where I first met you.
Yes.
And I loved your after work sessions. They were so nice. Ladies and gentlemen, he had it where it was open. You were welcome to come.
Yes.
And I mean, no cover charges. Come on in, y'all.
Right. Yeah.
And there was food available to purchase, drinks, and the best music in the world because people were coming to Las Vegas actually to be on your show, to get seen and
That's
hoping
right.
they could find an agent and a manager and get started in the entertainment
That's right.
field.
That's exactly right.
Yeah, so it's very, very wonderful, very exciting. So before we wrap up, I have to ask you, What are some of the best ways that people seeing us and hearing us can donate to this project to help this growth continue?
Oh, I thank you. I appreciate the opportunity. And you can go to, we have a GoFundMe account, www.gofundme.com/KCEPFM. And when you go on there, you can actually see all of the information. You can read up on what we're doing, where we came from. There's a little bit of history on the station and where we are. And then you can just make your donation. And it's going to go towards, you know, developing, to further develop the internship program. And right now, we've upgraded. We invested, I would say, a lot of the funds into upgrading the equipment, which was a huge leap and bounds for the radio station being 43 years old now.
And it was necessary.
It was
very
necessary, yes. So right now we're looking to continue to develop the interior of the radio station, you know, with office furniture, but also we need computers for the interns and just a whole lot of things are still needed. But the main part was to upgrade the equipment so we sound good.
Yes. When you say computers, everybody's got computers around the house. Yeah. What, do they have to be brand new computers?
Well, we prefer brand new
of
computers
course.
Because of the network that we have.
HD, yes.
Yes. And the network of streaming and everything that we're doing. We prefer to, if you would donate, you know, financially, and then we will purchase it so it can all be uniformed and work in harmony with the system that we have.
Wonderful. That is so great.
Yeah.
I have to ask you, just in case people are wondering.
Sure.
When we talk about donations, I like to tell people, follow your heart.
Yes.
It doesn't have to be $5,000.
No, it doesn't have to be.
I mean, it could be, oh, wait a minute. You had something about, you have 2,000. Tell us about that.
Yeah, I was saying.
200,000 listeners.
We have an average of over 200,000 weekly listeners on the radio, and that's just off the tower. And that's not even including the streaming, because we have streaming worldwide. We have people all over the world tune into KCEP now, and they follow us. So we have over 68,000 followers on our tuneinradio.com and search Power 88. And they're from all over the place, being that Vegas is a transient town. So they hear us and they take us home with them. So we have people in Europe, Africa listening, and they always donate online. That's how we know. But the 200,000 plus listeners, we said if everybody gave $10, that's $2 million.
So easy. Well, for my group here at Happy and Better TV.
Yes.
We're going to donate $100.
All right.
to your fundraiser.
Thank you.
And we hope you will come back and remind the people that this is something ongoing.
Yes.
It's an investment in ourselves.
Yes, it is.
Because the more we can improve our station,
absolutely,
the more enjoyment we get on a daily basis.
Absolutely. The future is in the youth, and the youth is the future.
That's
right. And that's what our focus is.
Yes, it is.
Yes.
Well, I want to thank you for joining Happy and Better TV today, Craig Knight.
And I feel happy and better.
Well, thank you so much. Thank you
You're
so
welcome.
Much.
Thank you for having me.
My pleasure.
God bless
my pleasure.
You. Yes.
Well, join us next time for another exciting chat.